It was the sort of performance to make even grown men cry. Even famous grown men.
Brilliant.
He's not sailing, by the way, he's flying, believe you me. His beloved Celtic have given him a reason to believe. And they are on their way. And look at that. No shame from Rod Stewart. And why should he?
Look at his mate, look.
Getting a cuddle from the big...
Hey, on the show tonight, a sexy rock legend. So the ladies are feeling a bit frisky. Oh, yeah, they are. Aren't they, Nikki? I feel a bit sick. Let's start the show! But we've got a great show for you tonight. Singing legend Rod Stewart is on the show. Yes, he is. Hollywood beauty Cameron Diaz is here. I know. And my favourite comedian, Sarah Millican, is here. Hey, Rod Stewart has also been in the news this week. He was at the football match where Celtic unbelievably beat Barcelona. I know. Oh, look at Rod there in tears. Oh, I know how he feels. I mean, I cry whenever I have to sit through a football match. Over the years, Rod has been friends with all the musical greats. Elton John, Ringo Starr, Celine Dion. Yeah, all of them. Rod, of course, a showbiz legend. And you know, the strange thing is, he looks exactly the same now as when he was a boy. I mean, here he is on his first day at school. Yeah. Oh, there we go! There we go! I'm only joking. That's Rob with his lovely wife, Penny. I think around the time she was appearing on Strictly Come Dancing. Oh, good news. I think we've just spotted Bradley Wiggins on the sideburn. Hey!
Sit yourself down.
And lights, camera, and action, it's Cameron Diaz! Woo! Oh, nice to see you! All of the things. Oh, sit yourself down. Cameron, Rod, Cameron, Sarah, Rod. There you go.
We met backstage.
Were you chatting? Very nice. And as I said in the thing, Bradley Wiggins, of course, he was supposed to be here, but he can't because he was injured. But apparently he's on the mend.
Thankfully.
So if he's watching, get well soon. And as soon as you're fighting fit, you can be back here on the couch. Someone else is recovering from a big shock. We saw you, Rod.
Don't get me started again.
No, seriously. Oh. You know what? I think you probably think we're going to love... It was so lovely how emotional we were. So, was the idea that, like, there was no way known Celtic could beat Barcelona?
Yeah, they're supposed to be the best team in the world, and they are, really. They're a brilliant team. If you know your football, they're the best team to watch. It's, you know, it's to take them on and actually beat them is... just wonderful.
No, we've got the footage of you at the end.
I thought you'd have the footage.
Oh, no, but it's so nasty. It's sweet. Here you go. They've just won. And look, oh.
Silly old sod.
Oh, look. Oh, the poor boy. Who's the big guy beside you?
That's my best mate. He's a second-hand car dealer called Big Honest Al.
Is that the pinnacle of the dream now, or are you hoping they can go all the way?
Well, you know, they can go all the way now, getting to the last 16 of Champions League. We have a game against Benfica, which I'm sure you know about.
Yes, of course. And it's a tapas bar somewhere, isn't it?
We're going to get Spartak Moscow, which I'm sure Cameron knows about.
I know nothing.
Hey, listen, let's talk about Rod Stewart's autobiography.
Yay! That's what I want to know about.
honest to God, it is quite the life you have led, sir. The stories in here, I mean, I blushed a little. And, and your lovely lady wife, Penny, did Penny... have you read this book, Penny? Did Penny know all the stories in it before?
Yeah, of course. She knows about everything. Yeah, absolutely. There's nothing in there that shocked you, was it, darling?
I knew I wasn't marrying a saint.
And also, but whatever about the inside of the book, all over it, because Penny took the picture on the front. Yeah. And how did Penny get that sort of little glint in your eye there, Rod?
She wore a very, very short skirt and no knickers.
I'm going to get killed when I go.
I didn't know that. I think what's unusual about the book is because, you know, we've read books of, you know, rock and roll excess and stuff, and they normally end up in quite a dark place.
Yeah.
But yours doesn't. Like, you didn't seem to have any demons. It just seems like you really enjoyed
it. It's a sunny book. It's really bright. And because I was never really, you know, I did drugs, but I was never mad on them. You know, they never upset my life. I never went to rehab. Didn't interfere with my marriages and my children. You know, I never even bought any in my life.
But when you look at all your contemporaries, you must feel really lucky.
Oh, yeah, absolutely.
But here you are, you know, happy and well.
Yeah, and come out the end really well.
And the other thing that really shocked me was, you know, when you started and when success hit, the amount of money that was knocking around. I mean, it was instant, it seemed. What was that amazing... You know, you bought a beautiful gift for Elton John.
It wasn't that beautiful.
Well, it sounds fancy.
Do you want me to tell a story?
Yeah.
OK, Elton and I were... Elton and I were really good mates. So, he's a very generous man, and I love him dearly. So I thought... I went into Harrods and I saw this ice box. And what you do is you press a button, and the table comes up, and the champagne comes out with all the glasses, and there's all colourful lights, and there's froth coming out. It's gorgeous. So I thought, it was £300, which was a lot of money in those days. So I gave it to Elton, he came round, I gave him his Christmas present, he said, here's yours, dear. It was a Rembrandt. How cheap did I feel?
I love that,
you're
lovely.
It was a Rembrandt, yeah. Oh.
Now, one of my favourite sections in the book, and this is so you. So, you know, the story of his life, but then every now and again he'll stop for, you know, a discussion of something. So there's a whole section on your hair.
By public demand.
No, because your hair, I mean, it's signature hair.
It is signature hair.
Yeah. So when you started, I mean, the work, because it was all your own work in the beginning.
Well, it was actually before hair dryers and hair lacquer when I started this haircut. We used to do it. I saw guys when I was busking as a beatnik in the 60s, and they had their hair all backcombed and bouffant in Paris. So I came home and started doing it. So what I used to do is put, you know, warm water and sugar in my hair and just wait for it to dry, because my mum didn't have hair dryer. Swear to God, I had to walk about a mile to go to my sister's to dry my hair. So that's how I got it up. The hair, that is.
Yeah, yeah, of course.
Warm water and sugar gets a lot of things up. Oh. It gets me up when it's got a tea bag in it.
You found a style, and my God, there's a picture of you and Freddie Mercury, and look, it's the same. It's the same...
On a theme.
But it's the same hair. So have you ever thought about changing it?
No, it will never sit down. I've tried other hairstyles like yourself.
And it won't
going
bald.
It doesn't. It won't lay down.
My hairstyle.
You should go see Wayne Rooney's doctor.
But what if
it's brilliant what he's done.
But what if it falls out again?
He's a footballer, by the way.
Oh, okay. Thank you.
And look at your hair. I say look at your hair, but really we're looking at the outfit. That's a fabulous picture.
Look at the old pump and tool bag there. Look. Oh.
It's just fabulous, isn't it?
It's
just fantastic.
It's amazing. Where are the men like you today? That looks like a good time.
Bless you.
But isn't it true your hair is like a barometer of how you're feeling?
Oh, yeah, absolutely. If I get sick, me and Ronnie Wood are the same. You know, he's in the Rolling Stones. You
know. I know who he is.
Yes, when we get sick, our hair just collapses. Does yours? Does yours just go
when you get sick?
When you get sick?
Yeah, usually.
And yours?
Look at it. I'm possibly ill. But, Cameron, is it true that you wanted a Rod Stewart hairdo?
the first haircut that I ever paid for, that I actually, that my mother didn't cut in the kitchen with the orange-handled scissors that went, that we cut open the boxes with, was she took me to the mall, and I ended up walking out with exactly, I wanted the Rod Stewart haircut, and I came out with, it was more like the, I'll show you which picture it was.
Okay.
It was...
We'll be here all night because there's a lot of good pictures.
Oh, is there?
That
okay. Yeah. It was more... Well, yeah, you're right. But anyhow,
it was a good plug for
it
the book.
It was a very... Yes, I'm going to take... Yeah. What? Oh, wait, I've just fallen into the words of this book. I can't take my
eyes
off.
It's an absorbing
story. Oh, yeah, so it was this one, more like this this hairdo right there.
Oh,
so, like,
okay.
Super short on top, the crop, and then a little bit longer. Yeah, oh. The crop top.
Let's see what you might have looked like. If you stare into camera 5 there, see that one there? Let's just see what you would have looked like with Rod's hair. Now, can I just... What I'm saying is, you don't look bad.
Oh.
You don't look bad. But have you ever seen have you ever seen EastEnders?
Oh, this is too. This is why I don't have an iPhone, is so that I don't do the apps on there, because I'd be all day long, I'd be like taking pictures of myself, like, and then like putting different haircuts on.
Do you want to go, Sarah?
Yeah, I love it.
Okay.
Do it.
Oh, wait, now, we
it's
just
so
need to
much
go.
Fun.
You want to cover up? We're going to. Oh, we're going in close.
Don't go too close. So you'd have seen the real one.
It was a little bit November there for a second.
Well, it's doing November.
Oh, is
he's
he?
Doing it, yeah, quite like it. Oh. But I've decided I'm going to do Fanuary. Have you heard of Fanuary? It's a thing. You just sort of let it go to rack and ruin.
Girlfriend who is obsessed with having a 70s bush. I mean, she is obsessed with it. And when she takes a bath, it like literally sways like seaweed. All of our girlfriends were like, would you please, just trim it, please. I can't take it anymore.
Christmas.
And now her husband's in on it. He's like, really, seriously, I can't take it anymore. One time...
She's got a boyfriend?
She's married.
Oh,
But she... No, that's how much he loves her. But one time we had like a total... We took her into the bathroom. We pinned her down. She had just gotten out of the bathtub. We all lost our mind because we were like, the seaweed was going. So we pinned her into the shower. One of our girlfriends had a pair of scissors and a comb, and the other three of us were holding her down like against the wall, and our friend was in there like
Is there any footage? Any footage?
But it was one of that kind of It was hilarious. It was literally one of the funniest things ever.
I love the seaweed of it. So it's a lovely time for you to have written this book, kind of looking back, because there's one picture in the book that I think is just such a happy thing, and you must be so pleased when you look at it. It's you, it's all your kids, it's your grandkid, and then the woman you love took the picture.
Yeah, she did.
Oh. So, I mean, that must just...
Yeah, that's a lot of children.
Yeah, it is a lot of children.
I didn't have a television.
But then, because, you know, you're a very hands-on father, and the book, again, you've got a great section of tips on parenting. And they're proper, like, they're proper hands-on tips.
Well, some of them are pretty brutal, you know.
Yeah, well, you know, tough love. I like your packed lunches for your kids.
Yeah,
talk us through what you do with the packed lunch.
Well, that's a... Oh, Graham, that's a long story. Because I love model railroads. So what I do with my son, you know, he's only 6, I put in his lunch bag little tiny people, a little bit of rail, anything that throws him, and Celtic things that makes him think of his dad when he opens up his lunch.
Is there any lunch in there at all?
Penny, you do the lunch, darling.
There's lunch in there as well.
Not much room for it.
I'll just end up eating the people.
The best one in there is when your teenager or your younger children won't get up, flood their bedroom with alarm clocks where they can't get them. Or a tape of bagpipes outside your door.
But now, in terms of rumours, I couldn't believe it when I got to that bit in the book. Rod Stewart is the source of the Nile, ladies and gentlemen. Seriously, he's the grandfather of all rumours. We've heard this rumour about so many pop stars over the years. I thought it was Mark Almond. I thought he was the source of that. But it's you.
I'm going to go behind.
I'm not going to tell it. I can't tell it, but I thought you could tell it. Because
do you want me to read it out?
do you mean the one about the sailors?
Yeah.
All right, here we go. I used to have this gay publicist that worked for me, and I had to fire him because he did something terrible. And he was a mean bitch. So he spread this rumour that I was with half a dozen sailors in San Diego giving them blowjobs. And I'd be taken to the hospital to have my stomach pumped.
I remember that when I was a child, hearing that rumour. I mean...
My kids were at school.
It's terrible.
But is this like Cameron's
rumour? This is the shit they make up.
Is this like Cameron's rumour that's, like, a little bit true? Like, have you... Did you just get on your face?
No, I believe we've got footage of the first time Rod heard that rumour. Yeah. Not you as well! Get off me! Get off me! Well, Rod, you might like to clear your throat because it is time for music. Now, your musical career, it's just had this extraordinary divide in it, where you'd all your... And then the American songbooks came along, and you've now got a new one, and this is Christmas, Merry Christmas, Baby.
Merry Christmas, Baby, yeah.
But very exciting that in the new year, after... Is it 17 years?
Of
not writing your own stuff, you are...
Yeah, thank you. Yeah, there's a new album coming out, like a rock album, next year, which I've written 11 songs for, which is...
That's not... Wait, we love this stuff. It'll be great to hear the old one again.
Plenty of songs in the old violin yet, Graham.
Ah, lovely. So, what are you performing for us tonight for the Christmas
Have
album?
Yourself a Merry Christmas.
Ah, lovely. Well, if you want to go get ready with the orchestra...
Thank you, ladies.
There he goes. Lovely. So, in a moment, we'll have this week's stories in the Avengers right there. But first, getting us in the Yuletide mood, it is Mr. Rod Stewart!
Your heart be light. From now on, our troubles will be out of sight. Have yourself a merry little Christmas. Make the Yuletide gay. From now on, our troubles will be far away. Here we are, as in olden days, happy golden days of yore. To us, gather near to us once more. Through the years, we all will be together if the fates allow. Hang a shining star. Christmas now. Through the years, we all will be together if the fates allow. Until then, we'll try another
Thank you. Seriously, you've been fantastic tonight. Thank you so much. Have a seat there.
Welcome back.
Beautiful.
Awesome.
I think I had something in my throat.
Well done, everyone. And you've got to join us on the show and have a go in the red cage. You can contact us via our website at this very address. Thank you to my guest tonight, Sarah Milligan. Children in Need, but join me in 2 weeks' time with actress Helena Bonham Carter, comedian Jack Whitehall, globetrotter Michael Palin, and singing star Michael Bublé. Yeah. I'll see you then. Good night.